Thank you so much for having me, and thank you for those of you that, you know, were here this morning and wanted to hear our testimony. We sincerely appreciate it. We're glad you're all here. My name is Claire Culwell. I am from Texas. I have lived the majority of my life here in Austin, Texas, and I am here to testify in favor of House Bill 16. I am 31 years old, and I am adopted. I always knew that I was adopted, and I decided to meet my birth mother 10 years ago. And when I searched for her, I thought the worst thing that could happen will be that she doesn't want to meet me. Little did I know that I would find out that I had survived her abortion that was meant to take my life. My birth mother sat me down in her home after we met, and she started to tell me about her life at the time that she was pregnant with me. She said that she was 13 years old. She didn't know she had an option. Her mother drove her to a local abortion clinic in Oklahoma, and she had an abortion, a late-term D&E dismemberment abortion. They told her that her life would go back to normal, but 4 weeks went by and her life wasn't going back to normal. Her pregnancy seemed to still be progressing, and she went back to that doctor where they told her that she had actually been pregnant with twins, and the abortion had successfully aborted my twin, but somehow I had survived. They tried to get a second, they requested a second abortion in Oklahoma and a third request for an abortion in Kansas, but due to the risk for infection, they weren't able to do that. And so I was born a couple weeks later. I weighed 3 pounds, 2 ounces. I had dislocated hips and club feet and other complications that may have been a result of the abortion, but after recent consultation with doctors, we think that probably that was because I shared that womb space with my twin. And so that makes my story even more miraculous than I knew it to be all these years, because an abortion that ripped my twin apart limb by limb left me untouched. And I'm so thankful that I am able to be here today and for the miracle that is my life. There has been a lot of debate. A lot of people aren't sure, or maybe they're in denial that abortion survivors exist. They obviously do not want to see our faces because it destroys what they have believed about a woman's right to choose and what the baby actually is. And so I, you know, sit here before you today with two other abortion survivors, and I want you to know that we have names, we have faces. Abortion survivors really do exist, and this bill that would protect our life and giving us medical care after we're born alive, during or after an abortion, in my case, that it really does affect people like me. I have a daughter, so it doesn't even stop there. It doesn't stop at protecting my life. I have a 6-year-old daughter. Her name is Sadie June, and I can't imagine my life without her. But the day that I had her, I held her in my arms that very first time, and I realized that that little girl that I was holding wouldn't be here if that abortion had successfully taken my life, and especially if I had been left to die on the table and not adequate medical care that I deserved. Providing babies with medical care, babies that survive abortions that are already born, this shouldn't be, as Representative Leach said, this shouldn't be something that we are talking about. This shouldn't be something that we are debating about or not showing up to vote about. This is something that is taking the life someone that lived through an abortion procedure, as traumatic as that is, and then is being left to die on an abortion table or on a medical table that is living, breathing, crying, can feel pain, can feel being left to suffocate and die. These are actual babies we're talking about, living babies. And so I would ask you to vote yes. You know, abortion, not only does abortion not empower women, if we'll talk about this as a women's issue and still under the label of abortion rights. Abortion is not empowering women, but having a mother leave her baby to die after the baby survives, that certainly is not empowering women. Not only that, but that certainly would not have empowered me as a woman if I was left to die on that table in the hospital after I survived my birth mother's abortion that took the life of my twin. And so I just want to thank you. I do want to ask you one question before I hand it off to these other two ladies. What about me? What about my face makes me less human or less deserving of a chance at life than someone like you who was wanted? So thank you. Thank you so much. And please vote yes.